get up and close and personal with Olympic skating coach Li Yan, whose speed skating team brought home the long gold from the PyeongChang Games right after this break. Welcome back. You're watching World Inside with Tian Wei. Beijing will host the 24th Winter Olympics, with nearby Hebei Province also hosting games in the year 2022. Earlier this year, in February, China finished the PyeongChang Winter Olympic Games with 1 gold, 6 silver, and 2 bronze medals. The only gold came from the short track speed skating team. As the coach of the team and also a retired skater, Li Yan has always been the team's rock. Earlier, I caught up with her, and she shared with me some experiences in PyeongChang and the future of China's winter sports. How do you assess your performance this time during the Winter Games in PyeongChang?
I think we do well, because, you know, gold medal always is standard for their performance. So Wu Dajing get 500 meter gold medal, and also he broke four times Olympic record. Olympic always hard, you know. It's because everybody expecting doing very well at a certain time, we call Olympic game. So this is why too many athletes have under a lot of pressure, and you know, like they won't do well. So all the pressure come to one point. It's really hard to present themselves. It's similar for our team. So because our team, you know, during like a 12 days competition, we our expectation pretty high at a certain events, like a distance. But we didn't get, you know, what we want at some point. But our team spirit, like fighting spirit, still there. Mm. This gold medal is the last day, last moment.
Exactly.
It's we're waiting for so long, and the really, once we get it, that's like a pressure and exciting. It's different.
Do you have to control yourself in front of your athletes?
It's not. Like I said, it's a practice. It's just myself. I didn't pretend to do that. Maybe at some point, little bit emotion,
yes,
come up, but that's really short. That's short time. Most of the time, you really have to come to do what you're supposed to do.
Yes. Have they learned? Have they learned from you the skills?
See, 12 days, last day, Wu Dajing get a gold medal. This means, you know, we overcome our difficulty time.
Ms. Li, on the one hand, you got a lot of these tasks. China wants to hold the Olympic Games, host the Olympic Games, and therefore want Team China to do well, right? On the other hand, you've got these post-90s generation.
No,
so they have very different personalities, right? So you have a lot of pressure tasks, but at the same time, you have to adjust to the current generation, how they interact. Tell me about how you do it.
Like my daughter is a teenager, 13 years old.
I heard you talk about that before.
And, you know, the athletes are the same. They are just get younger and younger. I think they teach me, I teach them. The new thing is a lot come from them. Mm-hmm. All the younger athletes, it's really good. That's the thing, you know, you with the young people, you're learning stuff, new stuff. You never feel you're old.
How do you see China's prospect in the coming Winter Games?
Beijing Olympic is a huge thing. It's a big thing for country. It's not easy to hold Olympics in different countries, but especially in China, because this requires a lot of stuff, like you know, all the rings, like you know, ice and snow, you know, those stuff. You should have like a lot of knowledge to put this together. Also for performance, you want to do well at home, right? Everybody want to do well at home. So also, this you have a lot of hope and wish, and you try your best, but also you have you're under a lot of pressure as well. I just wish we can do well for China at the Beijing Olympics. Like, we try to bring our team to reach as higher as we can. to represent China in Beijing Olympics.
What is your plan now? Do you have already a set plan about leading up to the day of Beijing Olympic Games?
You know, like winter sports is never and is big enough in China for now. But after Olympic, for sure, will get bigger and bigger. A lot of people will, you know, join the winter sports, either for fun or for, you know, for the career. I don't know, but for sure will be a lot of people be there visiting the sports. The plan is you should have a goal. The goal is if you want to get a gold medal or you can, you want to be in the final, so you need to start right now. Once you have a big goal, you will try to do your best. You will overcome a lot of hard time. So this really require a team for the leaders like coach. And athletes will follow same path to do a lot of stuff to make sure you are, once Olympic come, Beijing 2022 come, you're ready for that.
Of course, your team now are made up of different ages. Some of them will stay, some of them will leave by the year 2022. What is going to be the priority or criteria for you to choose whether someone stay or someone has to go?
So the plan is team 1, 2, 3. So from junior to senior, so all different age group. We're not cut for the age. You know, which age you can perform well is not because of that. It's because of ability. If you have ability to help in the team, if you have ability to win the medal for our country, so yes, that person will be chosen. So, but we always be prepared, like always. Like, it's not even 4 years right now. It's every single day all counts.
What a pleasure seeing you.
Thank you.
Thank you. All the best.
Thank you very much.
And that is all the time we have for today. If you'd like to see more, try to find us World Inside CGTN into your search engine or check out our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Sina Weibo. From me, Tian Wei, and everyone on the World Inside team, thanks for watching. And tune in again next time for insights across China and around the world. Good night.